Really? I tell Tim that if they start evacuating Manhattan, that I don't plan on coming in on Monday, and he says, I've already used all my floating holidays this year, right? I tell him, Dr. Venkman, catastrophic exodus of the city doesn't count as a floating holiday. No, it doesn't. I looked it up. So he hands me the employee handbook and tells me to look again, and that what is and isn't covered is very clearly defined. What? Yeah, it was in there, in his handwriting, in pencil. He wrote it in when he asked me to get his coffee. Anyway, I can take a half day on Monday if they evacuate the city. All right. Goodbye. Well, if they go ahead with this franchise thing, I can tell you one thing. I am not schlepping out to Brooklyn or Philadelphia or God knows where every time someone needs a fresh pot of coffee. Right. Right. Thank you. Goodbye.
I wouldn't mind running with these other ghouls away from the trouble.
Where's the fun in that?
Any guesses on where we'll find Peck and Alyssa?
I suspect that we're going to need the Super Slammer up there. No telling how powerful Peck has grown.
That means we gotta take the Ecto-1. I'll drive.
Maybe the trainee should drive.
Nah!
Thanks, Winston. Any ideas? Pretty spry, even with that 100 pounds of proton accelerator.
Ow! That was ow there!
Make your way around to the other side and open this gate for us.
We saw that kind of atmospheric disturbance?
That's right. At Dana Barrett's building, the night she turned into a dog. I don't get it. We shut down the Mandela. How can all this still be happening?
Gozerian Codex, it's written that a blood sacrifice and a tremendous amount of spiritual energy are needed to generate the supreme destructor form.
A destructor form? Again?
Peck probably couldn't draw sufficient energy from the mandala before we shut it down. He found an alternate source in our containment unit.
The The energy of the escaped ghosts from our grid might be enough to produce a cross-dimensional event in itself.
Yes, and with Alyssa here, I'm sure her Shandor ancestors aren't far behind.
I'll go with the intern. Nobody should wander around alone in this place. We'll meet you guys a little further on. very happy about us being here. You saw them too, didn't you? They think they're sneaky. Let's spread out and flank them. Flanking means I go this way and you go that way. I know you're new, but that's basic stuff.
Close one! Watch it! Painful. Get behind something. You own that creep. Stay on it. Come on, let's go!
All right, young blood, it's all you.
Give the rest of us a chance. Give him the what for? Yow! Check your aim!
Cosmic residue is by far the least pleasant aspect connected to this gear.
Never saw what hit him.
Thank you.
There's the key.
It's too heavy to carry ourselves. Get it back to the gate so we can keep going.
Friendly. Wait a minute.
Oh, I get it now. This has been bugging me. When the necromantic shockwave summoned Gozer back to our plane, why didn't he assume a more effective destructor form immediately? I mean, the Marshmallow Man is scary, sure, but there has to be a better way to destroy the world. It's simple. When he enters our plane of existence, he must be locked into that form from our first encounter. One destructor form per god per dimension. I like it. Sounds like the kind of symmetry these things tend to operate on. Hey, so maybe I didn't choose such a bad destructor after all, huh?
Come on!
Look, up there. It's getting worse.
This isn't the Central Park I'm used to. You still have your wallet?
Take a scan. That means one of two things. Either we're in trouble or we're dinner.
Is there a difference?
Hey, we have a test of proton packs in the ring?
That's what the recruit is doing right now.
Great! Wait a minute! I'm wearing one too!
That's true, Ray. How's it going so far?
Do you smell any burning or experience any painful tingling?
You'll be the first one to know. Or the second.
Airstrike! Take those flyers out! They're coming out of the ground! We gotta smash the coffins while they're airborne! Otherwise, we have to deal with these! They ain't all graceful.
Close.
down! On the right! Ooh. It's not alone! Ah.
I think you're gonna be all right.
Solid vaporization!
I think you're gonna be all right. Wow, very impressive. I think you're gonna be all right.
Could be trouble. On the right. Ooh, damn, that stings.
Come on! We're close. High. It's a whole bunch of them. Just don't do it.
out, would you?
You own that creep. I'm on it! Damn!
Man down, man down! Where do you think you're going? It's not alone! On the right!
You own that creep!
Wham! Right where I wanted you!
You own that creep!
Scan it! They felt that one in Pittsburgh! Don't quit! Kapow, creep! Hornet's nest, kid. That's a nice start. Of yours! Ow! Hey, here, come on.
Well, hello there.
Rick, you guys all right? Man, there ain't nothing dead in this graveyard.
Thanks for joining the party.
They're throwing everything they have at us to stop us from getting to that mausoleum.
That's as far as I can go. You guys got a clear path for me.
Ray, readings here are extremely unstable. Energy from the mandala and the escaped ghost is building up to a flashpoint. We don't have much time.
Yeah, that's good. Thanks. Rolling on.
Graves pushing up through here really did a number on this place.
Walter Peck is going to have a lot to thank you for when this will be parts apart.
If we can prevent the apocalypse, that is.
Could be trouble.
Clear out those roots.
Ah.
close on him, Rook.
Slime time!
Hey, over here, little help? Yo, little help?
We've tried everything. This metal is psychonically charged, rendering it effectively indestructible. Well, in such an extreme situation, I suppose it's possible to cause it harm, but I don't think anything we have is going to make a dent in it.
Then what's our plan?
Ray, you two check out that side.
I think I'm picking up something odd here. What's your take on this? An indestructible gate attached to a damaged frame. A few concussive hits and the hinges might just break loose.
Twelve o'clock high.
They're too well protected. Our energy streams aren't going to hurt them.
Peter, go kick them. The only hope we have is to stay alive and keep them away from the Ecto.
I wholeheartedly agree with Rick.
More precisely, they're little stone angels capable of attaining speeds of 198 feet per second.